I would like to ask EU governments a simple question. How could continued relations with this barbaric regime be considered legitimate? Has anything changed under Rouhani? The UN Secretary General and special rapporteurs on the situation of human rights in Iran say no, nothing has changed. The reality goes far beyond this. There is no such thing as human rights in Iran. This regime has founded its pillars on the blood of 120,000 executed political prisoners. 30,000 of them were executed in 1988 in a matter of few months. Since Rouhani became president, at least 1,200 have been executed, including at least 8 adolescents. At the same time, the suppression of ethnic minorities, such as Arabs, Baluchis, and Kurds, as well as the arrest of Sunnis, Dervishes, Christians, and Baha'is have stepped up. This is indeed the meaning of moderation under Rouhani, which is used by some Western governments to justify their illegitimate relations with the clerical regime. This regime lacks any capacity to reform. Western governments have sacrificed human rights to bridge relations with the religious dictatorship. This regime has no capacity to accept a deal which would guarantee abandoning nuclear bomb. The regime is facing an impasse. It wants to end the international sanction, but at the same time, it fears the consequences of abandoning its means of survival. Now that new officials have taken charge in leading the EU, the European Commission and the Foreign Policy Organ, it is expected that they lead a new initiative to defend human rights in Iran. A new approach should include the following. Political and commercial ties with the Iranian regime are subjected on improvement in the situation of human rights, especially a halt in execution and torture. Those responsible for these crimes, namely the regime leaders, must face justice. The Iranian regime is forced to implement fully Security Council resolutions, halt uranium enrichment, and accept snap international inspection of all suspect sites and centers. And the siege on Camp Liberty, especially the medical blockade, is ended, and Liberty's life is handed over to institutions that have no ties with the Iranian regime. The realization of these demands not only benefits the people of Iran and the region, but is also crucial to global peace and security.
We need a cultural and religious alternative to drive back a violent interpretation of Islam. But this is exactly what the PMOI, as a progressive and democratic Muslim force, and Mrs. Rajavi have done in Iran. I believe that the present crisis has significantly increased the value and importance of the Iranian democratic resistance to bring about peace and stability to this region.
Avant toute chose, je tiens à saluer la présence parmi nous de Madame Mariam Rajavi, présidente élue du Conseil national de la résistance iranienne. Madame, nous sommes nombreux au sein du Parlement européen et dans les pays de l'Union européenne à vouloir vous exprimer notre soutien et notre admiration pour le combat que vous menez depuis tant d'années pour que le peuple iranien, libéré de la dictature, connaisse bientôt la liberté, la démocratie et le progrès.
Any further EU relations with Iran must be strictly conditioned to clear improvements in human rights, or else we risk becoming complicit in these atrocities.
Les responsables de Daesh ont dit la même chose. Nous voulons reconstruire le califat. Et donc, ça veut dire clairement que la même vision de la politique, la même vision d'un État dictatorial théocratique est portée à la fois par les mollahs d'Iran, mais aussi par les fous de Daesh. Donc je crois que votre combat aujourd'hui est légitime, parce qu'en combattant les mollahs, vous êtes en train de combattre aussi pour le droit des peuples, mais aussi pour le droit de concevoir les religions à travers le monde comme des espaces de paix, comme des espaces de liberté, et pas comme des folies meurtrières. Merci Madame Rajavi, merci à l'ensemble des combattants pour un Iran libre.